Good evening, dear learners. I'm Dr. Satish Vishwambar Lakde, and I'm working as an assistant professor of communication skills in the Department of Humanities and Sciences, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. And I welcome you all for this session on Precis Writing. Now, here's the learning outcome. At the end of this session, students will be able to write Precis of a written passage or text. Now, here's a question for you to think over, and the question is, what is Precis Writing? Now, this concept is not new to you because you have studied this concept in your school. So, I request you to pause this video for some time and write the answer for this question in your course journal, and then you can resume the video. Welcome back, and here's the answer for the question, what is Precis Writing? And the answer is, Precis is a summary of a written work. So, in short, Precis is a summary of a written work. Now, let us understand Precis Writing in detail. A Precis is a summary, and Precis Writing means summarizing. Thus, Precis is a summary of a written work or text. Precis Writing is an exercise in compression. A Precis is the gist or main theme of a passage expressed in as few words as possible. It should be lucid, succinct, and full, that is, including all essential points, so that anyone who reads it may be able to grasp the main points and general effect of the passage summarized. It is not an outline but a shortened version of the original text. If well written, it can be substituted for the original passage or the text. Main ideas and the substance of the original work should be included in the shortened version. Now, let us discuss the steps for Precis Writing. So, these are the steps for Precis Writing, and we'll look at them one by one. First, carefully read the passage, if required several times. Apprehend clearly its main theme or general meaning. Second, identify the purpose of the writing, that is, what the writer wants to convey. So, it is important to understand the purpose of the writing. Three, write down the key points of the text you think are important. So, it is very essential that you write down the key points or the important points of the text. Four, build a rough draft around the purpose or main theme. Five, read the original text again and again and see if your points remain the same or if you can narrow down to exact points. Six, compare with the original work to check if the essence is fully maintained. Seven, check grammar. And eight, finally, identify a suitable title and write the final draft. So, these were the steps for Precis Writing. So, you should follow them. Now, here's a note. It is generally accepted fact that a Precis should be 1/3 of the original text in number of words. Therefore, it is important to keep a count of words. So, mind well, when you write a Precis, it should be 1/3 of the original text. Now, let us discuss about condensing. In condensing, aim at remodeling than at mere omission. So, it's better you remodel rather than omit words which can be main points of the passage. You may omit mere repetitions, illustrations and examples. Change figure of speech into literal expressions. Compress wordy sentences and alter phrases to words. Now, let us discuss some of the examples of condensing. So, these are the examples of condensing. Now, the first sentence, his courage in battle might without exaggeration be called lion-like. And this sentence can be condensed into a short simple sentence like, he was very brave in battle. The next sentence, the account the witness gave of the incident moved everyone that heard it to laughter. Now, this lengthy sentence is compressed into a simple short sentence, and that is, the witness story was absurd. Next sentence, there came to his recollection, and this is compressed into a very short sentence like, he remembered. So you can just see the difference between the lengthy sentence and the compressed one. The clerk who is now on his employ. Now this lengthy sentence like, the clerk who is now on his employ, is compressed into a short sentence, his present clerk. The next sentence, they acted in a manner that rendered them liable to prosecution. So this sentence is shortened into, they acted illegally. Now here is one more example of condensing. Look at the original sentence. The England of our own days is so strong and the Spain of our own days is so feeble that it is not possible without some reflection and care to comprehend full extent of the peril which England had from the power and ambition of Spain in the 16th century. Now this lengthy sentence is compressed into a short sentence which goes as follows. We cannot nowadays fully realize what a menace Spain was to England in the 16th century. So you can see the difference. A lengthy sentence can be compressed into a short sentence, which is given here. Now let us discuss condensing in indirect speech. As per the rule, a precis should be written in indirect speech after a verb of saying in the past tense. For example, now here's a sentence. Whether we look at the intrinsic value of our literature or at the particular situation of this country, we shall see the strongest reason to think that of all foreign tongues, the English tongue is that which would be the most useful to our native subjects. Now this sentence is condensed in indirect speech, which is as follows. Lord Macaulay said that England's noble literature and the universality of her language made English the foreign language most useful for India. So you can see here, this long sentence is condensed into a short one, which is just into two lines here. Challenges in precis writing. Now these are the challenges of precis writing. Precis writing has two major challenges, which are as follows. Identifying the key points. Sometimes the given text has elaborate discussion and examples, and so it is difficult for readers to identify the key points or the essence of the text. It requires thorough understanding aided by careful reading to identify the key points around which the precis needs to be written. The second challenge is writing the key or main points in your own words. Writing in one's own words is a challenging task. It is necessary that one should not copy the exact sentences from the original passage during precis writing. Knowledge of vocabulary and grammar is required to convert the key points to a well-written precis. Now here are some do's and don'ts in precis writing. First, do not judge the original text. The main idea behind precis writing is to give an essence of the text, reviewing its broader implications. It is not a review of the text as such. Second, do not refer the original text. Precis is not a write-up by you referring to the original text, but it is a summary of the text or passage. Therefore, one should avoid mentioning the text like in the article or in the passage, etc. in the precis. Third, do not use abbreviations or contractions. Fourth, use past tense while writing history. Now let us discuss advantages of precis writing. Writing precis develops careful reading. Precis writing requires careful reading of the text several times to understand what is essential and what is not essential. It improves vocabulary as one has to write precis in his or her words. It also improves your creative writing skill as you write the essence of the text in your own words. So these are the references for this particular work. And I wish you a very happy learning. Thank you so much.